In order to do this, you've got to saw the carcass between the 12th and 13th rib. You count up 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. You want to saw on this vertebrae and try not to leave more than half on the hind quarter. And with a very sharp knife, make one clean, straight cut. Once the ribeye is exposed, you need at least 10 minutes bloom time.
So once the animal is ribbed, we let it sit for approximately at least 10 minutes to let the product bloom. At the processing facility, we state an ID number, a date, and a weight. This is identification for this actual carcass. So then we set this up here above the ribeye so that when we bring in our hood system, it's within the picture so that once we capture the image above, we then can remove this tag and put it on the chime and then recapture the chime so that both the ribeye face and the chime are sent within the program so that the inspector can properly grade the beef. Okay, so once the tag is properly placed at the top of the loin, I'll take the hood system with the lighting. You'll have your camera set up in here with the program already ready to rock and roll. You'll bring it above and then you capture the image. Then you take the hood away, you then inspect the image for quality assurance for the sending off to the program. Then after that point, I'll move this down to the chime. So now we're going to take a picture of the chime on this half, and we'll take a picture of the ribeye face on this half. So what you want to do is have your tag identification set right there. Bring your hood system up here. Take the image. Then you want to step back, look at the image, make sure you have a clear view with your tag in place. Turn, do the same thing on the ribeye on this side, and make sure you don't cover up the ribeye when you're doing this with the hood system. So you might take a little bit of time to get placed. Again, take the picture, pull it back, make sure the surface area is all encompassed and that you can still see the tag for the identification purposes.
Program would have the ranch to table certified Angus beef set up. The live animal characteristics of predominantly black would be photographed in the pens, or it could also be photographed on the rail with the hide on. From there, it could be identified with a blue ink on the hock or an actual A stamp on the rump. Once the carcass reaches the cooler, then we would go through the G1 schedule specifications. On the G1 schedule program, the specifications are for the certified Angus beef, carcasses cannot be over 1,100 pounds, carcass weight, ribeye size not less than 10 inches, not more than 16. For me to identify these carcasses, I will ask that they place a grid over the ribeye itself so that I can get a determination on how big the measurement is of the ribeye. Also, the fat requirement for a certified Angus beef is 1 inch or less of back fat, and you place your ruler approximately 3/4 the way up the ribeye and take the back fat measurement. From there, you have to have a modest zero or higher for it to qualify for the quality grade on certified Angus beef.
Once the images are taken, they're sent to me via email. I'll then log into my USDA cloud vault that they provided us. Once I'm in our cloud vault, I will create a folder for the date that we took the images on. Once that folder is created, I can come down here, click on that folder. Right now there's no files in here, so I have to upload the files into said folder. I'll then upload those images, uploaded, I can rename it to the calf's tag number, the date, the grade, whatever it might be, and then we're done.
Once the processor notifies me that the images have been uploaded to the cloud vault, I go in, I record the actual carcass number along with the carcass weight and what I graded the carcass. I then have a form, a grade form, that I put the today's date, the carcass number, the actual hot weight, the grade, the particular plant, and I put a check underneath the certified Angus beef for each carcass that qualifies for that particular program. This form is then sent to the processor to apply the grade stamp for the carcass that was reviewed that particular date.